It's like everything everywhere is going crazy, so we don't go out anymore. We sit in the house, and slowly the world we're living in is getting smaller, and all we say is, please, just leave us alone. Well, I'm not going to leave you alone. I want you to get mad. I want all of you to get up out of your chairs and go to the window, open it, and stick your head out and yell.
The Dean Blundell Show.
This is mass madness, you maniacs.
102.1 The Edge.
So today, folks, three people in the United States won $218 million because they had that. Was it 640 by the time it was all said and done? $640 million lottery, the Mega Millions jackpot. I think it was Illinois, Maryland, and Kansas. Three tickets sold from each place. One person's going to remain anonymous. The one person's coming forward today, and the other person, they don't know yet.
Yeah, because in Kansas, you can remain anonymous. That's why.
Yeah.
So in the other states, you have to disclose who you are, but in that state, for some reason, their laws are different.
Which is silly, I think.
I think so, too.
You have to tell everybody who you are if you won $220 million, because all you'll have is a bunch of beg friends, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, if any of your family members leaves tomorrow and you never hear from them again.
Canadians were going down doing stories. Canadians were flying down there to buy tickets. People were flying down to buy Mega Millions tickets, so hopefully you feel like a huge jackass if you spend $2,000 to fly down to go get some tickets. But I want you to listen. This is a story. Derek forwarded this to me this morning. And this is a story that a Canadian news outlet did on the frenzy down in the United States. But you got to listen to some of these people how, like, they're already spending the money.
Today's lineups started before dawn.
Show me the money, baby. Show me the money.
Yeah, baby. Show me the money.
All for a chance to win what's being advertised as the biggest lotto prize ever, anywhere.
It only takes a dollar and a dream.
The jackpot is more than $640 million. That's upwards of half a billion. Billion with a B. The chance of winning is almost...
Thank you for that.
I'm glad they had to explain that to us.
Yeah. Thank you. Understand our large denominations now.
Maybe for Americans, you never know.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Was nil, about one in 176 million. Still, Americans are dreaming big.
I think I'll take it.
This makes me laugh. I think I'll, this guy has won the lottery already. He's in line to get a ticket, and he's spending the money.
Are dreaming big.
I think I'll take a cruise around the world. Buy a Maserati.
I'm going to give money to everybody. I don't want none of it. I just want a little bit.
It's Whitney Houston. She's back.
But I don't want anybody.
I don't want none of it. I just want a little bit. We'll give it away.
Put some in the bank and quit my job.
But other potential winners aren't thinking of themselves. In states that were hit hard by the recession, some are planning their own economic stimulus plans.
Open all kind of businesses. To put a lot of people to work.
That's nice. What kind of businesses?
What are you gonna do?
Yeah, you know.
I have plan. Me have plan. What's your plan? Open all kind of business. Me have good plan.
Sounds like he's put a lot of thought into it. Yeah.
A business here.
Yeah.
Over there.
We'll sell
back here,
goods
and up there.
We'll sell goods and services.
We sell things.
Lottery tickets.
Lottery. Look at how stupid we all get over the whole crap. Listen to what he's going to do. This guy kills me.
All kind of businesses to put a lot of people to work.
Aww. And across the country, workplaces like this salon are pooling their money and buying blocks of tickets together.
That's so much money for one person to have that, you know, I think a group should win this money.
It's Woody Allen. He's buying lottery tickets.
Seriously. I think we should win this money at this hair salon. You know how much streaking and frosting stuff you can get for people? You get one of those combs that goes right through the hair.
So, can a Canadian get their hands on all that U.S. cash? The rules say you don't have to live in the States to win. You just needed to buy a ticket there. We'll know tomorrow if there's a winner or winners. If not, the jackpot just keeps getting bigger.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Imagine how pissed it would have been a Canadian one then. Huh?
Well, we don't know.
Yeah, that's true. So maybe some one of the morons that flew down to Maryland for
Well, there's another story, a sort of post-draw story, and the person that won north of Baltimore,
yeah,
it was a one-off quick pick.
Yeah.
Yeah, did you?
Like, run in, $1 here, and give me one of those tickets, because it was like $640 million, and they won.
You hear this guy going into the store that where it won?
No.
Listen.
I love this.
That's the winning machine. That's the winning machine right there. Touch it.
Dean Blundell Show.
I don't give a fuck what you do.
102.1.
Keep that radio station and shove it up your ass.
The Edge.
The Junos were yesterday.
They were?
The Junos.
Waka waka.
Sheepdogs did well.
Yeah, they won a couple of awards.
Which awards?
The
single of the year.
Okay.
For I don't know.
Yeah.
Help me. I think probably newcomer of the year as well.
Mm-hmm.
And that chick Feist won. Who's hot? Derek said she's hot, but
I thought the picture, she looked really good.
No, she looked pretty
red
good.
Dress.
I wearing. Saw a little bit of her. Yeah.
Did you saw how much of her did you see enough to?
I didn't see her face.
That's the what? Problem.
With yeah. Her.
The problem is face.
You just chose not to look at her.
Yeah, I only looked at her body.
Oh, I see.
Well, and what's the problem? Is her body okay, or is it?
Yeah, body's pretty face? Good.
2012 Junos, just plain weird.
The biggest stars weren't there, Dean. That's what people were upset about.
Who's that?
Like the Justin Beeb. Bieber.
The Beeb wasn't there.
They were interviewing two probably 25-year-old ladies outside who were talking about how much they loved her and had tattoos of Justin Bieber on them and showed their tattoos.
Okay, so see, look at here's Feist in a red dress, and her body is killer, and her face is like a 98-year-old librarian's.
She looks a bit like she was tanning a lot, right?
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah. Okay. She looks like she was tan. You know, she looks like she should be. Arranging flowers or something. She doesn't look like she should be winning. Oh, she won 3 Juno Awards.
Mm-hmm.
What'd she win the awards for?
Best album, I heard. Or Artist of the Year, I mean.
Is that Bruce Cockburn in there? Oh, it's the guy from Blue Rodeo.
Cockburn.
Yeah. Okay. Headley was on stage, I see. I'm just flipping through.
Yeah, he did well, too.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, and the Arkells did okay.
What'd they win?
Oh, did the Arkells do well?
Yeah, they won some things.
Dallas Green won Songwriter of the Year.
Buble wasn't there, what I was going to say. He was the other big star.
Oh, but the good news is Carter Nello Fischel was there.
Oh, right.
So was Ruthie Lamb. Deadmau5 was there, Todd. That's kind
of
cool.
Oh, dude, to this day, that is one of the funniest things I've ever done.
When you hit him in the head.
Yeah, I thought so. And he's like, stop it. And I'm like, clink, clink, clink. That was at last year's. Now, you know, it's funny because I was thinking about this. Juno's last year in Toronto. I'm like, they should always have it in Toronto. And then this year was in Ottawa. You know where it is next year?
Saskatoon.
Regina. It's in Regina. That's like someone
the
taking the Grammys.
Stars to play in Regina.
Yeah.
Oh, and putting them in
Redbud, Illinois. Where they want, you know, like
Gary, Indiana. Yeah. Dude, I'm going through these. I don't know half these people. Like Alyssa Reed and Ann Julie and Linda Ortega. I don't know who that is. Jane Burnett. Who's that?
Don't know either.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Mm-hmm. Deep Dark Woods. Who's the Deep Dark Woods? What's a dragonette? Hmm. What's Jennifer Abel?
Did we play dragonette at one point?
Oh, Sarah McLachlan looks pretty hot.
Yeah, she always looks good.
Oh, that she was a highlight. Honestly, her and Blue Rodeo.
I thought it was her and Bruce Cockburn.
No, okay.
That was later.
It was a really good performance. That's the only thing I saw, and it was worse.
Oh, okay, good. So anyway, the Junos were yesterday. Sheepdogs won. Congratulations to them.
Yeah.
Other than that, nothing to write home about, except for William Shatner being... Got to give him credit, too. He made fun of himself pretty much for 2 hours, didn't he?
That's what he does now. That's his thing.
You know what she's worth? I heard this weekend.
100 million?
Up a little.
250?
Up.
350?
300.
300 million?
$300 million.
He's 81. Why doesn't he just quit?
Is he 81?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he did great for 81 then. Wow. That guy is focused.
Only thing missing is an Oscar.
Yeah, 81 years old.
Wow.
Anyway, congratulations to the Sheepdogs. We'll just say that.
Yeah.
Time for a look at Edge traffic again. Did you watch the Junos, by the way?
Unfortunately, no. I was watching Celebrity Apprentice.
Yeah. How good was that, though, last night?
Arsenio is my hero. Sorry.
Yeah.
She needed to be put in her place.
I couldn't agree more.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I don't know because I didn't watch it. She's talking about
Aubrey.
Yeah, Aubrey.
Aubrey
O'Day. Oh, the chick from the red-haired broad?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love her.
She's evil, though. I don't like her
dude,
at all.
Dude, I would let her wreck it.
Would you?
Yeah.
She would wreck it.
Yeah, I know.
She would. She'd tear it up.
The Dean Blundell Show. Oh, wow. Mornings. On the Edge.
So they gave out the Mega Millions jackpot lottery in the state. $640 million went to three different people, about $218 million apiece, from what I can understand. Pardon me. We played you some clips. Now, Todd, there were some other clips of people losing their marbles yesterday.
Yes.
Oh, so yeah, after the lottery was announced, obviously people now are like totally pumped to see not only if they won, most of them didn't obviously, but they wanted to see the stores like that gave away the winning tickets.
Well, because they get money too, if I'm not mistaken, right?
I heard $500,000
each store. To each store, half a million bucks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't know. Why is that? That's cool.
I'm not sure. I know it happens here too. I think if let's say you win $40 million in the Lotto Max or whatever it's called, then the store gets a huge chunk of money too, I believe. Is that correct?
Well, I guess.
Marlo. Marlo, yeah. Is that true? You work at a meat store. No? Yeah. Things get crazy at the meat store this weekend? Do you have a fight with the deli department this weekend? Did you have a fight in the deli department this weekend? How was the guy making salads? Was he pretty cool? Salad guy? Was he all right?
No, it was a pretty calm weekend.
Okay. A lot of macaroni salad getting off?
We actually don't have the macaroni anymore.
Oh, okay.
Oh, no. Is it going to get nuts, though, for Easter weekend coming up?
Yeah, we have a ton of catering orders. Yeah, actually.
Here we go.
For sure, little sandwiches. Anyway, sit down. Thank you. You're done. What were we talking about?
Lottery and people going crazy.
Yeah. So anyway, yeah, but apparently the one of the ones that was sold, and you said, and this makes me laugh, some guy ran in at 7:15 p.m. It was like an hour before the draw. Some store in Maryland did a quick pick. Dollar. Here. Boom. Then he's $218 million richer this morning.
Insane.
Isn't that nuts? But the people's reaction is the funnest. What do you have here?
Here's some more. Just someone going into the store.
Okay, good.
Only one ticket purchased.
Touch the winning machine. That's the winning machine right there. Touch it.
See you for the next time. Good luck. Good luck.
This kid's touching it.
Each winning ticket is worth $213 million.
That's the winning machine. Touch it.
I was hoping it was me this morning, but got, as you can see, we're on our way to work. So, I don't know. Good luck to whoever won.
The second winning ticket was sold at this Moto Mart not far from St. Louis.
I think it's awesome. Awesome.
The third winning ticket was bought somewhere in northeastern Kansas. The exact location hasn't been disclosed. The state's lottery director has some advice for the winner.
We sure want to meet the winner, but we want to tell him, sign the back of the ticket and secure it.
No. That guy's crapping his pants.
Yeah.
Whatever you do, sign the back of the ticket and secure it. You don't want anybody taking no money, you know?
Americans spent nearly $1.5 billion for the chance to hit the Mega Millions jackpot. The $640 million record dwarfs the second biggest jackpot ever, $390 million, which was split by two winners who bought tickets in Georgia and New Jersey in 2007. Carlotta Bradley, the Associated.
Oh, well, there you go.
There's another one, too. I don't know. You want to hear if there's some reaction here? Okay, I think that we got some more here.
Yeah, Ford saying they are the big winner.
The Moto Mart Gas Bar and Convenience Store was all abuzz in tiny Red Bud, Illinois.
Yeah.
Couldn't wait to talk to somebody and yell at somebody and share it. It's like, you can't believe it. You won't believe it. And I just, oh my God, we sold the winning ticket.
When news of someone in their midst had shared in the largest lottery jackpot ever, well, folks got to talking.
I bought one last night, too, but it wasn't me. I only got two numbers.
It's in the cards. You're either going to win it or you aren't.
What? Red Bud.
Well said, ma'am. The most sound observation from this whole lottery. It's in the care you don't. Yeah.
Population 3,500 is about an hour east of St. Louis. There was a Red Bud mentioned in a movie once.
We're looking for a Dog Creek Road. That would be near the town of Red Bud.
If I was going to Dog Creek Road, I sure as hell wouldn't start from here.
But alas, that Red Bud in the movie Funny Farm was in Vermont. As of now, this Red Bud is much more famous.
What does this matter?
I don't know.
Get to that Asian guy. That made me laugh.
Here we go.
This guy makes me laugh. It's awesome.
Oh, wait. Which one's at the... I don't know which one you're talking about. I think you have it.
No. The guy's like, and all you can understand was Mega Million.
Oh, yeah. Here's the news report. Yeah. Listen here.
已经打破全美奖券历史最高头奖金额纪录之后， 全国各地掀起一股抢购这项名为 Mega Million 超级六合彩的热潮。 主办当局在星期五中午宣布， 仍在不断。
And one time in Chinese.
掀起一股抢购这项名为 Mega Million 超级六合彩。
It was big
That's
everywhere,
so
man.
Cute.
It was big.
That is so cute when they say that. Do it again.
金额纪录之后，全国各地掀起一股抢购呢项名为 Mega Million 超级六合彩嘅热潮。
It's a worldwide story.
I know.
Everywhere.
Mega Million.
头奖金额纪录之后，全国各地掀起一股抢购呢项名为 Mega Million 超级六合彩。
Why is that so funny? Anyway, congratulations to the three people that won it. Your life will be immeasurably worse.
Attention, citizens of Florida. Attention, citizens of Louisiana.
The Dean Blundell Show.
It's going to be category 5 or greater.
102.1.
I'm dizzy.
Time for listener email. Hey guys, Rob Ford and his brother are supposed to weigh in today, even though they skipped last week. Any guesses as to how much they will weigh?
I'm going.
Keep it moist, Danny.
Sorry.
That's all right.
I'm going maintain.
Was he 308 the last time? Was that what he was?
310, I think.
308.
Was it?
Yep.
Okay, 308 then. I say he stays put.
I say up 6 pounds. I'm going big this week. I say Tub of Guts is going to be up 6 pounds. It'll be like 314. 313, 314, if this is the price is right. And I bet you his brother, same thing.
But I don't know.
Those guys, honest to God.
Yeah.
Have the willpower of my Wang. Zero.
Not so good.
Yeah, it's pretty tough when you put it that way.
Yeah.
No, I think he's going to be just a couple pounds heavier because we didn't see him a lot last week.
No, we didn't.
So I'm wondering if he was just like sitting in a hot tub.
Chained the fridge closed.
Yeah.
Sitting in a steam room, you think?
Just like sweating it out. We are like wearing tons of clothes.
That's
like,
cheating.
I who knows?
Yeah, sweating it out. I gotta sweat out those chicken wings. Can you sweat out the chicken wings, or are my pores too small?
Can I eat them again once they come out?
I'm gonna binge and purge. Oh my god! I beat anorexia. I always forget the purge part after you binge. I binge, but I forget the purge. I just get so hungry. I just keep eating. I forget the purging because I'm not so hungry.
People can live through bulimia. Look at me.
Look at this. Yeah. Poster child.
You said I've never conquered anything, but I conquered bulimia big time. And anorexia, nervosa. I don't have an eating problem. Nothing is any problem for me ever.
I was a gaunt 180 pounds.
Remember when he was trying to convince everybody he worked out? Does he think we're retarded? Like, he's doing this weight challenge and he's lost 22 pounds in like 7 years or something. That's like a half an ounce a month.
Yeah, and he started off strong, but that's what they say.
Yeah, like the first week he lost 10 pounds or something. So he's really, if you put it in perspective, only lost like a pound a week. I don't know what his... I don't even care, to be honest with you. God, he's like a... Remember when he said he worked out?
I love this.
Listen to this.
I love the interviewer.
Yeah. Here with Rob Ford.
All right, we're here today with Rob Ford. And Rob, you just finished your workout.
So tongue-in-cheek.
Funny already. Funny already.
How's it going? And
Well, I just did 4 laps, and then I went down Islington Avenue.
I know you did it. I just did 4 laps around the hot dog machine, and then I walked down to Eglinton, but I was already here, so that worked out.
The Dixon and Long Dixon to Kipling came back up, did another 4 laps, so we ran about 3 miles today.
Nice.
A little tired, but we're doing it.
Nice.
We're doing it.
Guy couldn't be more condescending.
I love that guy.
Nice. Ooh.
Every day we're doing well.
That looks like you've been working out bench wise. What are you benching now?
This is the best. This is when he gets to like forget he's a big fat guy. Here he forgets he's a huge pig, and he thinks no one can see him. Yeah. It's like he's got the emperor's new clothes on.
You've been working out bench wise. What are you benching now?
We're just curling and doing some bench. So
yeah, yeah.
Trying to stay in shape. Okay. I don't know, my max bench is probably about 250. That's my just one side, but.
Once up, huh, bud? If it gets up.
It's so funny.
Sit-ups.
I'd be interested to see if you could do a sit-up.
Or how many?
Oh, get out of here.
Maybe if you put a donut on the other end.
Yeah, and a little all the way up. Or if you rub some carrots on some donuts and then held the carrots at the top. Hey, listen, they're carrots, but they taste like donuts. We glazed the donuts for you. We glazed the carrots and the celery.
Okay. All right. Here we go. That sounds good.
I'm just going to lick the carrots.
That'd be funny to watch.
Hold it. Wait. Where's the glazed carrots?
Yeah. Everybody waits for the dip for like the veggies, like the ranch dip.
Yeah.
Excuse me. You wouldn't happen to have any donut glazing, would you? That could dip this in?
Or that gravy dip?
Excuse me. You wouldn't happen to have some butter?
Yeah.
I'm going to dip my carrots and celery in the butter.
Can we give me a cheeseburger for it?
Karen, a cheeseburger.
That's a good step.
Excuse me. I wouldn't mind dipping my wheat germ in some pizza. Could you do me a favor? I'll have the chicken pecan salad on a pizza. With a side of hollandaise. Just use that for the dressing, goddammit.
You're listening to the Dean Blundell Show on 102.1 The Edge.
This is your Edge.
Damn it. Hold it.
Files with Dean Blundell on the Edge.
Wanda Derby, 71-year-old lady who obviously doesn't like gay people, charged with hate crimes after attacking her openly gay neighbor for being gay. Lloyd Guerrero, 25-year-old, was hit with a cane a few times. And this happened in Texas. Guerrero, who's an actor, said he was being attacked and has been yelled at and cursed at many times. Why would I tell you about it when there's a news story and Lloyd Guerrero can tell you about it himself? It's truly a sad story, though, because you'd think to yourself, in this day and age, people would stop doing this kind of stuff, but they really haven't. Like this lady's 71, so she's probably, it's from the old school.
Being gay is terrible.
Have a listen.
Her door when we knocked just a little while ago.
Honestly, it looked like something out of a TV show. Like she just like whacked, and I will say she hit pretty hard.
If anybody knows about being whacked hard, I tell you it's Lloyd Guerrero.
Oh, I thought that was his sister.
He's the authority on someone whacking him hard.
No, it's him.
Yeah, he knows a hard whacking when he gets it, this Lloyd Guerrero.
Lloyd Guerrero, a 25-year-old actor, says his 71-year-old neighbor, Wanda Derby, attacked him with her cane.
She just kept like that.
He still
has... You got to see him do the action. Yeah. The action is exactly what you think it is.
Like this.
Oh, no.
Yeah, and it's like... he
looks like
totally,
a whacking.
Totally familiar with that kind of whacking.
Listen. She just kept... Like that. He's still
his cheek didn't swell up? No, okay.
Like that. No, didn't.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm pumped up though.
76-year-old man named Michael Stoltz admitted to shooting. This is old, crazy old people
day. Yeah, really, right?
Admitted to shooting and killing his wife, Bernice, who wasn't even 50, and their two dogs over an argument regarding poop on the floor. He's scheduled for a mental evaluation. Apparently claims he was frustrated with his dog's habit of pooping in the house. Now, anyone with a brain knows you're not supposed to complain to a dude who's just come to the realization he's got a poop to clean up. That's when his wife started yelling at him, telling him to clean it up, and he said he had had enough.
Oh.
Yeah. Not good.
Sadly, they haven't had a dog for 10 years.
No, no, they had two of them. They don't anymore because he shot them first when he went to the bedroom.
Oh, he did shoot the dogs too?
Yeah, he got a rifle, unloaded it into the dog's skull, killing it, went into the other one, killed the other dog. And that's when Bernice apparently ran screaming into the kitchen, and he goes, "Hold it!" She turned around, looked at him, and went... Boom!
No, no.
Just the one time. Jeez. Yeah, it's a sad story anyway. No one would be pooping on the floor anymore. When the police showed up, they said, "What'd you do?" He goes, "Got sick of the poop on the floor, so I shot everybody." And he went and sat in the police car by himself. Yeah, you knew.
Yeah. What, crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah, good aim? What do you say? Like, I don't know.
Not bad.
It's pretty good aim for an old guy.
Job done. And when Danielle Parr, a homemaker from Texas, accidentally ejected a tampon from its applicator, the last thing she expected to find were marks all over it. That's what she did find. On closer inspection, the mother found what appeared to be a large number of black moldy spots covering the tampon.
Oh, why are you telling us this?
I'm really grossed out.
But I can handle a dog getting shot with, like, right to the head.
Yeah.
You start talking about moldy tampons, bud?
Okay. That's it. I am out. Okay. That is gross and sick. What's this world coming to?
You guys are so much more horrified by a moldy tampon than some guy killing everybody because the dog pooped on the floor. That is unbelievable. You guys are the worst. You guys are like the most morally bankrupt people I've ever met in my life. I sat and watched you guys. I said the words moldy tampon. Thoroughly puked
up. Not only us.
Rightly so.
Yeah. I tell a story about some old guy killing everyone he loves, including two puppies, and you guys aren't even fazed.
Yeah, stuff happens. People get shot. Yeah. But very rarely...
You find a moldy tampon.
You don't see that.
She left it in there far too long.
You don't see that in horror movies. That'd be a good one.
Horror movies.
Horror movie. Yeah, the kind that Derek watches.
So she just found it like that?
Yeah. Nothing else to say other than you guys are total pigs.
That's all you wanted to do, eh?
You were just trying to draw that out of us, weren't you?
You guys are the worst.
Gross.
You guys are mean.
Yeah, we're mean.
I know.
Mushrooms.
Moldy tampons.
Oh,
sick.
Stop it.
Those are your edge files.
Tell some more murderer stories.
Yeah. Okay. Give us something lighter.
Hey, and he wore his dead wife's skin as a scarf.
At least he didn't have
moldy tampon. Those are your Edge Files, whatever the hell day it is in April, year 2012.
The Edge Files.
On 102.1.
The Edge.
The Dean Blundell Show.
Wake up.
Mornings.
Wake up.
We get Friday off. Does everybody get Friday off? It's good Friday.
Yeah, and Monday we don't have off, but a lot of people have Monday off as well.
Good Friday, unless you, of course, were the guy that was, you know.
He didn't have that day off.
Yeah, the good Lord. I got an email this week. I got to read this to you. I got an email from some guy this weekend. I had so much fun emailing him back, too. It was so funny.
Did you get in one at, like, a good little debate? Or?
No, there's no. You can't debate with a guy named... Well, I can't read his name. Dean. You like this. Hey, Dean, one of your shows, you mentioned the possibility that Jesus was gay. I hope someone cuts your throat and cuts your tongue out, you fat effing pig. Burn in hell, you fat effing pig.
Come on.
Yeah.
Is he representing the Christians here?
I don't know. So I emailed him. I go, Marco, are you gay?
or maybe a bigoted dickhead. Go away, Dean. Because I do email people back as much as I can anyway. Watch your back, and then he uses the derogatory gay slur for a gay person that starts with an F.
Oh, so cute.
Watch your back.
Mm-hmm.
F lover.
What a jerk.
Yeah. Watch your back, F lover.
I don't think it was such a bad hypothesis.
That Jesus may be gay? I don't think it was either. Do you have any Jesus music? Some kind of religious music? Maybe some humming or, I don't know.
Just some Pet Shop Gregorian Boys.
You're just throwing it out
Pet
there.
Creed. Do you have any Creed? Well, think about it like this. And keep in mind, folks, I say this all because I don't know. My brother's a reverend. My parents, my dad just got back from a missionary trip in India, and so did my brother. My sister, my whole family loves the Lord. So, you know, I'm speaking from a very serious perspective.
It's in church music.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah, it'll pick up. It starts with bells. It's
all right,
okay.
All right.
That's
all
nice.
Right.
And for the record, I don't agree with what you're about to say either, but it doesn't matter.
But it's funny.
It's funny, though. It makes me laugh.
Jesus had a sense of humor.
And people don't know.
No.
You're just throwing it out there.
But.
Wait a second.
If my dad told me, son, you're going to die a terrible death. Today is your last day. Have dinner with whoever you want. Who do you want it to be? If it were me, yeah. If I was the Jesus, I wouldn't go. 13 guys, man.
And one that doesn't actually like me.
Yeah. Just to make me feel a little dangerous. You know what I'm saying? God in heaven. I'm looking to have pita and hummus with 13 fellas. And I'm looking to wash their feet, too. That'd be so sweet. I got a real foot thing. How do you know Jesus wasn't a gay dude with a foot thing?
And while we're eating, we're going to have somebody paint
Muslim
us.
Music? What is this?
I know this didn't really.
You're an idiot. A hymn. H-Y-M-N. Hymn. Church hymn.
Rock of Ages or something.
Yeah, or I Surrender All or.
Blah, blah.
Oh, my blessed Savior. Anyway, that's more feasible if you think about the way life is. You think about the way humanity is today. It is more feasible for me to believe that Jesus H. Christ. What's his middle name again?
Herbert.
Oh, Jesus Herbert Christ had a thing for dudes and feet. And the last day he spent in this earthly fold, he was washing feet and eating pita bread with a bunch of fellas. Are you kidding?
You never know.
Do I have to explain it?
What a great time to have a foot fetish when they didn't even have shoes.
Ooh, these sandals are a gag. Yeah.
I can't even imagine what's under those straps.
You tease.
You and your closed toe shoes.
Oh.
Oh, look at him walking on water.
Mm.
Moist feet.
Oh, they're so wet. Oh, they're so wet. Oh, my God. Just his feet are wet.
Oh. You know, that makes me happy. You, John?
Oh, no.
Where's Peter? I am ready. Oh, he's building a Catholic church in Rome.
And what was up with Mary?
Town bike.
But did he eat in them? He didn't want a piece?
Well, new Mary Magdalene or his mom?
No, Mary Magdalene.
Oh, yeah, dude, she was a total whore.
But did Jesus have a piece?
Sure, she was in the picture, dude.
Okay, I don't know. I'm just
saying. She was the fluff girl.
Okay.
Jesus fluff girl.
Did you just say Jesus?
I'm just protecting myself.
Like, the lightning bolt. No, listen, God has a sense of humor, and he would understand that in this day and age, it would be, if someone told you that story about how this guy came down from some other planet or the clouds and lived 33 years and did all kinds of manual labor and never got married, and the last thing he did before he knew he was going to die. Yeah. Have a little hummus and pita with the fellas.
You said hummus, right?
That's right.
Okay.
You can do anything you want. What do you want to do? Hamath and Peter with the fellas, and I'm really interested in washing some feet.
Who's
all of their feet? Every foot in the place.
Draw the water.
Give me a sponge.
Let me get on my knees.
Loofahs. They have loofahs back in the Christ days.
But they're exfoliating? What? Yeah.
Jesus created exfoliation?
Yeah.
You are right.
Yeah. Okay.
Camel hair blankets.
What do you want to do before you go? Give these guys a foot makeover. Big time.
Yeah.
Maybe that was it. Maybe he's not gay.
Maybe he wanted to be like one of those. Maybe he was like an amateur podiatrist. You don't know. We weren't around. It was 2,000 years ago.
He's the original shoeshine guy. There's just no shoes.
Hey, mister.
He's just shining the feet.
Okay. Yeah, maybe he wasn't gay. Who knows? I prefer to stay with gay, though. Because if I had a choice to spend a night with 13 babes eating hummus and pizza bread or 13 dudes, I am not hanging out with the fellas.
And I wouldn't go with the hummus either. I wouldn't choose that.
I'd go with like a brisket. Last meal? Hummus.
Something a little less gassy and less garlicky.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's hard to make out with guys. Hard to make out with all those guys when you're garlicky.
They mustn't have been that exciting because they just kept falling asleep.
I know. And then how much of a stooge did he feel like afterwards where they denied him three times before the rooster crowed?
Guys!
Guys! Do you know him? You know that guy?
Never met him before in my life, but he couldn't stop washing our feet. Serves a brutal
What's that
hummus.
Part of the story?
Oh,
with the rooster?
Oh, you didn't know that?
No.
Yeah, like Jesus told I think it was Peter.
Yeah.
He'll deny him three times.
He would deny knowing him three times as he was going to get arrested for being the Christ, right? So, folks.
Before the cock crowed.
Before the cock crowed. So the rooster crowed three times. And he denied him three times. And then the rooster crowed. And he's like, oh, I forgot. Jesus told me I was going to deny
him.
But I think Peter was more like, did that guy wash your feet? He's like, no.
I did it myself.
You sure he didn't give you guys like manis and patties?
I don't know that guy. Look at him. He's a
That's
weirdo.
That's why I denied him.
Yeah. Don't you know that guy with the foot fetish?
He's protecting his own rep. Yeah, is that all he's doing?
Yeah. He's like, yeah, look at that weirdo over there, eh? Don't you know him?
I get it.
The Dean Blundell Show. 102.1. The Edge.
Hi. Time for listener email and some open phones. This guy? This George guy?
Yeah, he emailed you?
Yeah, yeah. That guy was like, I was offended by the chanting in your song. Earlier we were talking about how it's Easter and Jesus spent his last day with like 13 guys washing their feet. It's pretty homoerotic. It is. So I asked these questions. Maybe there was more going on with the disciples than we thought. Maybe Jesus had a thing. I don't know.
Well, you thought, because Derek disagreed wholeheartedly.
Well, Derek disagrees wholeheartedly and he's entitled to it.
Yeah, but I mean, you can.
But you're not offended by it.
Yeah, it's just it's an idea.
Could have happened.
It could.
Put a
who
question
knows?
Mark at the end of
all
it.
All stuff could have happened
it's
back
like,
in the day.
It's like the sacrilege when people say Jesus may have had sex with Mary Magdalene, and you go, "Oh, really? Well, I'm that religion, so you can't offend me, and I'm coming to get you." Now, I'm going to read you this email. Dean, I just got off the phone with you. As stated earlier, I'd like to consider myself an easygoing and fun person with a good sense of humor. But as a Greek Orthodox Christian, no, not born again, I found it extremely offensive. You played Greek Easter Orthodox music this close to Easter while calling Jesus gay.
It was the first thing that came up on YouTube, right? Yeah.
Just a pointer. Try to screen what you are playing. P.S. I wonder why you haven't played any Muslim chants while that Middle Eastern accent is Muhammad or general Muslim. Sounds pretty cowardly. You know what I love about this? And I just sent this guy an email back.
Tries to make it right for an eye for an eye argument.
Oh, my God. Well, just the supreme hypocrisy in what he's saying. I said, yeah. He said I was cowardly for playing the Greek Orthodox music because it offended him. Oh. I didn't go after the Muslims, too, he said. I said, what's cowardly is asking me not to use Greek Orthodox chanting because it happens to be your religion. However, Dean, feel free to go after any other religion because that would make him laugh. Rethink what you're offended by and either have someone more objective or smarter than you craft an email and try again tomorrow. Or just grow up. People pick and choose what to be offended by.
Mm-hmm.
I'm Greek Orthodox, and I happen to have some Greek Orthodox chanting in it, so I'm going to be offended. I'm going to pick and choose what I'm going to be offended by. I should stand up.
Stand up for nothing. Don't take anything personally, and you'll be just fine the rest of your life.
Thank God he didn't play Justin Bieber music in the background.
Man, you know, people wouldn't have been offended.
Yeah, he would have heard the end of it.
You know how, how many guys out there would be calling in going, stop that. Stop that.
Hey, the Edge.
Hello. How are you guys?
Hey.
How are you?
Good. Who's this?
It's Jeremy.
Hello, Jeremy.
What's up, dude?
Everybody at work loves you guys. We always listen.
Where do you work?
I'm an electrician.
Electrician? Okay. Say hi to the electricians for us.
So, there's a general thing that they don't like about your show, though.
What's that?
It's the music you play over and over again, the same songs.
Yeah, we know. We don't really pick it.
That's the complaint that most people have. But other than that, it's amazing.
Thanks, dude.
Thanks, buddy.
Appreciate your call. Have a great day, man.
You ever zap yourself? I want to ask him. Have you ever zaps himself? What a tough line of work.
Electrician, of course.
Yeah. One of them, no one is worse. I wish you didn't hang up on him so quickly.
Chances are there's other electricians listening, dude. Hi, The Edge.
Hi, I just wanted to comment on how Jesus could have had relations with his disciples.
Yeah, how could he have had relations with his disciples, that Jesus?
If he did have relations with his disciples, then our religion has to change because we're so against together relationships. And I think that we would need to reevaluate the whole Catholic system.
Thank you.
You're getting deep.
Thank you for that.
No, not really.
No.
I'm joking.
I totally don't even know what she said.
Me neither. I think she was saying
she's
that.
Like totally like wicked.
Hi. I want to say earlier that I really am complaining about what you're saying about Jesus Christ being gay because back in the day when he was wearing, it was awful. Like, look at those sandals. And his hair. That is not cool. And I don't think he's
laughing. Dude, he's going with the easy look, kind of. Yeah. The easy access look.
No. It's just appalling. You can't wear that in public.
So, how do you think Jesus should have dressed?
I don't know, like, a Technicolor dream coat would have been, like, much more appropriate.
Joseph did that. Right.
Well, I appreciate your input. Thanks, brother. Have a great day.
I am offended that you would say Jesus was gay, because he was a terrible dresser.
Okay. At the Edge.
Hi, how's it going?
Good, you?
Pretty good. I just got a comment about, I guess, the Catholic school board, and if people have a problem with the Catholic school system, or really the
I can't talk about the Catholic school system. Hi, The Edge.
Hey, how are you doing today?
Good, what's up?
Not too much. Is this what happened?
Nope.
Oh, it's not what happened today?
No.
It's whatever.
Yeah.
Whatever?
Yeah. Hi, The Edge.
You won.
Hi, The Edge. You won it, whatever. What's up?
Not much. Listen, I'm from the Hammer. We got an epidemic here, buddy.
What is it?
And not the kind you're thinking about either. I know there's a lot of people with rotten teeth and mullets and whatnot.
Dirty babes? Got some dirty babes down there?
Yeah, but they're everywhere.
All right.
Check out the chick that just called in from Toronto, no doubt. Bit of a dough head.
Yeah.
So what's your epidemic?
Huge epidemic, guys. It's called e-bikes. I'm going to start running these pricks over.
Oh, these are the guys that are on bikes that are electric powered that think that they're a hybrid between
like
a guy on a bicycle.
It's true. I heard you're technically allowed drinking on those things.
You're not, but you are allowed to drink on those things. The e-bikes, correct me if I'm wrong, dude. These guys seem to think they have the best of both worlds, and so they take up space everywhere, and it pisses everybody off.
Yeah, and they ride around with smoke from their pie holes, or not wearing any helmets, no protective gear, and taking up the whole damn lane.
Mm.
Yeah, they're bikes. They're meant to be pedaled. Like, they should be in bike lanes.
Well, that's the catch. They put pedals on these things. I'm sick of them.
I'm sick of them, too. You just look pretty silly.
Yeah.
Electric mopeds.
Hi, The Edge.
Hey, how's it going, Dean?
Good. What's up? Hunter.
Yeah, buddy.
Hey, what's shaking?
You know, my favorite way to learn the Easter story is actually through a gay porno that tells the life of Jesus Christ.
Is there a gay porn that tells the life of the Lord?
Yes, it is.
Which one is it?
I can't remember the name of it. I'm at work right now, so I can't look it up on the computer.
And what's the premise of the story?
Well, I can probably figure it out if it's a gay porn.
Yeah, basically he just bangs on his disciples.
The many temptations of Christ.
And Judas gets spanked a lot.
Sounds like a long movie.
It does.
Just get to the end. Resurrection.
Yeah.
Oh, Judas.
And you know, I got an email from somebody earlier too. I know Easter's coming up this weekend. But, you know, if anyone today rose from the dead, they'd be considered zombies and have their heads smashed in with lead pipes. Like, the, you know, if you put the whole rising from the... I know it's a nice story and it's a good holiday and the kids... But I gave my kids their candy yesterday. I gave them... We did
you?
Little, yeah, we did an Easter egg hunt. Yeah, because I'm not going to see
them.
Oh,
you won't see them next
yeah,
time.
Yeah.
I thought you were just trying to make your own holiday.
No.
Oh, okay.
By the edge.
Hi, it's Jeff.
Hey, Jeff. What's up?
Just talking about those e-bikes, those on slow-moving vehicles. There should be those warning signs on the back of them.
Like the little triangles?
Yes. It's actually part of the law system. Anything under 50 kilometers should be wearing one of those.
Mm-hmm. On the e-bikes. Thank you. Hey, the edge.
Jesus wouldn't even ride one.
No. Yeah. He was like, even that is way too really effeminate for me.
Oh, sorry.
Jesus wouldn't be caught dead on an e-bike. At the edge. At the edge. At the edge.
Yeah, yo.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who's this?
Hey.
Come on, dude.
Okay.
What do you got?
Nothing.
He's got great comedic timing.
High the edge.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, you?
Not too bad. I just wanted to call up and say I'm offended by your use of words with the letter E in them.
Enough.
It just grinds my gears.
Does it really?
Oh, yeah.
The use of the letter E?
Yeah, you should change your name to Dan so that it doesn't have an E in it anymore. That'll really make things better for me.
And Dirk instead of Derek.
Yeah,
exactly.
How could we talk about those e-bikes then?
Yeah.
They're just bikes.
You're going to have to figure that out.
Okay.
The Dean Blundell Show. Mornings.
It's so crazy.
On the edge.
Time for Wha Happened, and we've got some great stuff to give away today, don't we?
Yeah, the McDonald's $100 gift card and those Edgefest 2012 tickets.
Oh, he's got me touching it.
Yeah.
Got me touching on it,
rubbing it,
yeah. Slapping it, flipping it, rub it down. Oh no!
Picture it.
Yeah, you should. You totally sick. Should. I'm a little bit sick. Hi, the Edge.
Hello.
Hey.
I'm on here.
Yeah, who's this?
Jeremy.
Hey, Jeremy. What's up?
Yeah. This is a story from when I was a baby.
What happened?
My older brother actually told
me... Hey, what happened?
Hello?
Hey.
Yeah.
What happened?
My older brother actually told me the story.
What happened?
No. Hello?
Hey, what happened?
Can I go yet?
What happened?
Can I go yet?
You said it, Dick.
Yeah, that's the end of that.
No.
Hi, the Edge.
Yeah, he couldn't. He didn't know.
He could have just gone.
Yeah, he could have just started talking.
Hi, the Edge.
What happened?
Hey, what happened?
Hey, what happened?
What happened?
What happened?
What happened?
Yeah, we get it.
Go ahead.
Yeah, okay, I know I'm done too.
Okay.
So basically, long and the short of it,
My member had some jewelry. The jewelry thought that it looked better on the loofah in the shower. When I turned, got caught on there and decided that it was going to make a new home.
Sorry, sir. Your penis piercing got caught on the loofah sponge and ripped it right out?
Oh, yeah.
Son of a bitch.
Why would you get it there in the first place?
What it was telling me that I shouldn't have.
Ah, hang on.
Pull it out. Right. And but the original, I know it was in.
I know.
Hi, The Edge.
Hey, this is what happened.
Yeah.
What the yes. What happened?
So I was downtown.
What
had, like, three
happened?
I f***ed over like three Cinnabons and a beef patty.
Yeah. Hi, The Edge.
I actually want to hear more of that.
I know. He just said he effed over a couple of beef patties and a Cinnabon.
Hi,
The Edge. Hello.
Hello.
Hey, dude.
Hi.
Hey, what's your name?
What happened?
What happened? I was in the hospital a few years ago, and I have an escape in my pants, so the nurse have to keep me
up. Hold it. I like this guy so much. You're in the hospital for what?
I was in the hospital. I fainted on the job.
You fainted on the job?
Yeah, and I went to and something happened in my I escaped in my pants, so the nurse have to clean me up.
Hang on. You escaped in your pants?
Yeah.
What do you mean you escaped?
I pooed my pants. So the nurse had to clean me up, and she was so scared when she saw my third testicle.
Hold it. You fainted at work and crapped in your pants, and the nurse pulled your pants down to clean you up, and she got upset because you have three testicles?
Yeah, she fainted. She was so scared.
She's scared. You win.
Everything.
Yeah, ever.
What an interesting way to find out you have three testicles.
Yeah.
Got him.
You got...
He escaped in his pants.
So tell that whole story from start to finish real quick. No music if you can. Go ahead.
Okay, I found out the job and I went to the emergency and I pooed in my pants and the nurse had to clean me up. When she saw I have third testicle, she... She went unconscious and
were you born with three testicles?
Yeah.
The Dean Blundell Show. On 102.1 The Edge.
Open phones now. Time for open phones. 416-870-870-3343. Anything you want to talk about, we'll talk about it with you. And... do you remember the guy that was super wasted singing Bohemian Rhapsody in the cop car in Alberta?
Yeah, of course.
He may join us this morning.
Yeah, I'm talking to him via Facebook right now. And we're going back and forth of what time to call him. And the last, he said he'll call us. And then I said, we can call you, dude. Don't worry. And he's like, I only use Skype.
Seriously?
Oh, I don't know what that means. Can he call us if he only uses Skype?
You can call through Skype, yeah.
Okay, good. Okay.
Yeah. Hopefully it doesn't sound like...
Crap.
Oh, whatever.
It won't.
416-870-870-3343 for open phones. Do you guys want to hear more from the people people that played the lottery in the States? We played it this morning a couple of times. This guy's pretty funny.
I'm going to give money to everybody. I don't want none of it. I just want a little bit. I'm going to give it away.
Didn't want none of it. Want a little bit of it.
Myself.
This guy's classic, too.
Show me the money, baby. Show me the money.
Yeah, baby.
This guy's cool, too. He's going to have a good time. He's going to cruise around the world.
I think I'll...
Keep in mind, he hasn't even purchased the ticket yet.
Take a cruise around the world, buy a Maserati.
Are Americans by and large regarded as the stupidest collection of people in any specific developed country? Is that why they're hated? Because they're that stupid?
Yes.
This guy's standing in line and he's already spending the money on a Maserati and he has no clue that $220 million could possibly buy a large portion of that company itself.
I like this news story.
Which one?
The one that, because it was very global, right?
Yeah.
It was all over the world.
其无人中头奖及传媒报道累积彩金已经打破全美奖券历史最高头奖金额纪录之后，全国各地掀起一股抢购呢项名为 Mega Million 超级六合彩机。
Mega Million.
Mega Million.
Open all kind of businesses.
This one's funny too. This guy also hasn't played the lottery yet, but clearly won. So, this is what his plan is.
Open all kind of businesses to put a lot of people to work.
Wow. What kind of business?
Open all kind of business.
All kinds of business. Just gonna open them, all kinds. Put them over here and there and one over here. And why?
It says, to put a lot of people to work.
That's nice, isn't it?
Yeah.
It is very altruistic.
I'm sure his tune might change, though, if he actually won.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bye. Chances are.
They're going to work, be my butler, be my maid, be my servant.
Make me some bathtub cheese.
Be my driver.
This guy's classic, too. He sounds, Derek pointed out, he sounds exactly like Woody Allen.
That's so much money for one person to have that, you know, I think a group should win this money.
I never said that. It's crazy.
That's so much money for one person to have that, you know, I think a group should win this money.
Only I should have this much money.
Yeah.
At the edge.
Hey, good morning, guys.
Morning.
Hey, last week when you guys were saying that the Edgefiles, there was that Neil's restaurant that had the albino rhino.
Earl's.
All week we were kind of having fun with that and saying that she was upset about it. But if you just upset one person, let's upset everyone. So make everything on the menu something either racial or like those little slider burgers. Just make them dwarf burgers.
Yeah.
Midget burgers.
Yeah.
Exactly. Just make fun of everyone then so that she can't get upset.
Yeah. Or you do something to some type of food, and you make it like kind of like so it looks like it's broken, and you call it a disabled type of dish.
Exactly.
Or instead of supersizing something, you Rob Ford it.
Yeah. It's like Rob Ford says. fries come in a real bucket. It's the Rob Ford size fries.
Huh.
It's probably a good idea. Yeah. At the edge.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm calling this for open phone.
Yep.
All right. So, my friend, I go to Mac University. My friend had a business welcoming kind of thing. There's a little group that they have.
Mm-hmm.
So, he's already like a leader of this group. So he's already got the position. You have to do tryouts. So he just wants to have a little fun with it. So he calls escort to come to this tryout thing in front of all these like professional judges at Mac University. So they call him.
No.
Go ahead. I don't. You gotta know. Like when you call, you gotta know what you're saying. Right?
Yeah. Jot down point form.
Hang. Makes sense.
So boring. Damn it. Makes sense. Hi, The Edge.
Hey, how you doing?
Good.
Good. Hey, I just want to change off topics a bit. I just want to, you know, the RFC is going over to Mexico. I just want to wish them a safe trip. Pretty good stuff going on over there, and I read some articles. I don't know if you guys have, but Cartel runs the city that they're actually played in, and I just want to wish them great luck out there and safe trip.
All right, man. Thanks. They probably are all listening and thankful for that. Hi, The Edge.
Good luck.
Hello?
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
Good. Who's this?
Shireen.
What's up?
I was just wondering if you guys could play that clip of Josie singing the national anthem again.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Do we have it?
Thank you.
It's on YouTube.
Did you send it to me, though?
I can find it.
Yeah.
I think I just sent
it. Oh, you know what? It's on my blog. Yeah, dude, I felt so bad for her because that thing has been on TSN every day. ESPN, it's been on. It's been on every show.
That's so funny.
As a female, there's nothing more embarrassing than watching that for her, is there?
No.
Like, could you imagine anything more embarrassing than screwing up the Canadian national anthem?
She did a great job, though. She owned it, and she, you know, she was. It was just nerves. It's not.
Bucket list.
Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Tough.
Count deep our land. Help me, patriot love. I'm nervous. No, wait, one more time. This is my bucket list. It's my bucket list.
Own it.
Oh, Canada, we stand on native land. True.
Can you pause it?
Yeah.
She's technically right. We are standing on native land.
Native land, it's true. She's making a point there, I think.
Maybe she's actually teaching people as opposed to... Maybe she's using this as an opportunity to teach people about Aboriginal Caucasian issues as it pertains to...
Land rights
and reservation treaties.
No, I think she just messed up.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. But...
All thy sons
come. I see she's getting it here.
It says well now.
You know what's amazing is how much hate mail she got because she screwed up the national anthem from like Canadian Nazis. Like people that think Canada is it. And it is. But she didn't give up. I like this. Yeah. This is a great lesson.
Wow, there's some horrible comments on here.
Is there really?
Oh my goodness.
How many people have watched it?
There's like over 100,000.
Oh. Not pro. Sorry, can you play the start again?
I can't believe the comments people write.
Are they being rude?
You want to hear one?
No, not if they're rude. I like Josie.
No, I'm saying, no, Josie's been so cool about this situation.
Kids, if you want to learn from something about like when something like that happens, and it's going to happen inevitably to anybody, take a page out of Josie's book out of how to handle it with a sense of humor and laugh.
Yeah,
it
she's
off.
Being self-deprecating. She tried her best. She was nervous. It wasn't about her not being patriotic, people.
Yeah. What's the comment?
It is so horrible. Dumb.
Oh, no.
And then I feel the need to. No, I can't even write this.
No, I don't want to hear it. No.
Read this. I mean, watch your book.
Oh,
people are mean.
Are you serious?
A lot of, you know that word? I
oh, no.
A lot of that.
Oh.
What's wrong with people?
Jeez.
She didn't kill anybody.
I don't even know what waste of sperm means, okay?
I do. I totally know what that means.
Okay, sorry.
Big time no.
That's not a nice
people
thing
are
to
so
say.
So rude.
N-O. I know what that means.
Keyboard warriors, huh?
Yeah.
Strike again.
Play the start of it again,
here
though.
We go. Yeah.
I've got the item on our bucket list here at the Canada Center.
Oh, Canada. We stand on guard for thee. Count deep our land. Help me.
See, none of these words are not those. I'm sure I've read that anthem 100 times. They're not in that
you
anthem.
Know, say no, I'm nervous.
I'm nervous and help me do not appear. If help me appears in the national anthem, it's in the French national anthem.
The Dean Blundell Show.
What happened?
Mornings.
Do you have this guy on the phone yet?
No, it doesn't. I don't know,
calling
dude.
Us.
Supposed to be calling us?
Yeah. He only has Skype.
The drunk guy singing Bohemian Rhapsody. I don't think I want to talk to him now.
You don't want to talk to him?
Nah, he's too much of a pain in the ass. Like, we can't call him. He can call us. Sure, why not? I guess so.
I was drunk at the back of a cop car in Alberta, sang Queen's Bohemian Rhapsody. You know what they've done is they've actually matched it up to the song itself, mm-hmm. and the timing's almost perfect.
Really?
It's just proving once again, when you're wasted, you can do pretty incredible things. Hi, The Edge. Hello.
Hello.
Hey, who's this?
It's Vito.
Pardon?
Vito.
Vito?
Yes.
I thought you said Adolf.
Tough name, eh?
Yeah.
It's a tough phone.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
Hey, The Edge.
I was wondering what your guys' opinion is on the friend zone or brother zone.
The friend zone or bro zone. Explain.
Yeah. You have your friends. You're really interested in something, and then all of a sudden she's like, "Oh, we're more than like friends. We're like brothers, or even with females, like we're like really good sisters."
Do you have an
like
issue?
That.
Do you have an issue right now? You're going through.
A little frustrated.
Yeah, I personally think I am as well.
What is it? Tell me what it is, and I can help.
I know this girl that I like and known her for quite a few years, and all of a sudden I just started getting interested in her, and now I'm hoping that it would go further, but she kind of, like a couple of weeks ago, was like, "Oh, you're more than a friend, you're like a brother," and I was like, "Oh, damn."
Sir, just so you know, that's code for I'm not attracted to you.
Yeah.
Bingo.
Yep.
Unfortunately.
Yeah.
I know it sucks.
Might be
I
good if you're
bad.
In Alabama,
sucks,
but other than that.
You know, gotta let things live its own path. And,
well, why wasn't she good enough for you to like before?
I don't know. I think it's just I didn't see her in that way. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, you grew to love her. It's cute, but too bad, buddy.
Well,
move on.
I've never understood that, how guys can do that.
Oh, I do.
Like,
I know,
grow to become. Because my entire goal with women every time I'm with one is to have sex with them.
Yeah, mine too. So that's every guy's goal almost, so.
No, but you know, I hear what he's saying. Is that you can be with tons of like really, really hot women.
Yeah.
And then sometimes you're just kind of in the friend zone. And then you realize how special
that person is. No.
And then what you do is you look past the looks, Dean, is what happens. Is that you realize that beauty is within and not necessarily, you know, a big nose or something. And then,
dude,
and you're not getting any action at the same time.
Were you a
sucks, and you fall in love with your friend.
Yeah, totally. And then she totally wanted nothing to do with him.
Because you're like a brother.
So what happened? Did you guys ever fool around?
Pardon?
Did you ever fool around?
No, we haven't, no. We've made out and stuff, but that's really about it.
Oh, when did you make out with her?
Actually, New Year's.
Did you feel her up and stuff, too? Did you guys grab each other's junk?
Yeah, we did.
Okay, well, so there's something. She has started something, and you started something. I get it now. So now you've got a little bit of hope. She's realized the opposite, maybe. Maybe have you talked to her and said, "Hey, what's going on? Here's how I feel."
No, I haven't. But
most important,
sure if I want to, because it's a pretty good friendship that we have. Like we've known each other for 7 years. So.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Sir, are you bisexual?
Yeah.
No, I'm no bisexual. No.
Come on.
No bisexual.
Any interest in guys at all?
Hell no.
All right.
100% straight.
Well, there isn't a guy I know that's if. Every
that's
straight
100%
man,
straight.
Yeah. No.
Come on.
Shut up. Every straight dude I know, given the opportunity, even if it's with a chick, if it's a chick that they really, really like and she's even a better friend, they want to do it even more. So there's something going on here.
Yeah.
Well, what does she look like? Did we establish that?
No, we didn't, but I find she's pretty hot.
Did you always find that?
Pardon?
I always thought
she was good looking, but just recently I found that she was even more, she's just looks so much better.
Hmm. Yeah, that's interesting if their looks improve.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if they've improved if I've just seen her in that way. You know what I mean?
Yeah, are you sure you're not bisexual?
Yeah, I think you're gay, dude. Good luck. Good luck finding the man of your dreams.
Write her some poetry.
Hi, The Edge. Guys don't talk like that, though. That's the thing.
Yeah, nice guys.
No guys analyze female relationships, friendships. I've never used the word friend zone because it doesn't exist. I don't think friend zone exists. I don't want to wreck our great friendship, even though you've got a great body and I'd like to have sex with you. I don't want to wreck our friendship. Sex always trumps friendship. Always. We're weak people.
Yeah, I don't believe in plutonic relationships.
No, or platonic ones.
Did I say Pluto?
Yeah,
sorry. That's the ones from Pluto.
Yeah. Hi, The Edge.
Hi, Dean.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, this is Vito calling back. I got cut off there. My phone died on you.
Hey, right on.
Hey, how you doing, Vito?
Not bad, not bad. I was just calling on Friday. You guys were talking about vegans.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was dating a vegan chick a while back, and she had spent the whole afternoon talking about the lifestyle. Went back to my place, did the dirty, and by the end of it all, I said, "You're not a vegan," and she asked me why.
I know.
Said, "Because you just were sucking on my sausage."
He called back for that, eh? He really wanted to share.
Because she had his sausage, get
yeah.
it?
Ah, hey. You're no longer a vegan. Because you ate balls.
It's got a face.
Hi, The Edge. Hi, The Edge. Oh, I get it.
He's giving us the boring.
Yeah.
Well, he waited for that.
Hi, The Edge.
Hey, Dean, how's it going?
Good, what's up?
Pretty good. Listen, I got a buddy who lives out west. He's in the radio and whatnot, and I guess you're a legend out there because you had sex on air. I don't know if that's true or not.
I had sex on air?
Yeah, apparently.
No?
You're the only guy that they've known out there to be able to do what they do and have sex on air.
Oh, no, no, no. I didn't have sex on air. No, no, different, different. I had sex in the radio station, but not on the radio.
Oh, all right.
Yeah, in Alberta, right? Yeah.
Yeah, this is
yeah.
Alberta.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, it was good. It was funny. It was like, dude, it was like 15 years ago.
Who hasn't done that?
And I haven't here. Yeah. I don't know. Stories are going around. But it's, the story was, met a girl. She came to the radio station. We were wasted. It was like 1 in the morning. It's on a Saturday. And I may or may not have left some... I can tell you this, that the fellow that found the prophylactics next morning was happy that I engaged in safe sex.
So he didn't have to clean the couch?
Bingo.
Oh, okay.
No, the production room.
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh,
that's
wow.
where you make commercials. We tried to
You're not
baby.
Supposed to spill near the board.
Hi, The Edge.
Hey, how are you?
Good.
I can beat that pants escape artist there for What Happened.
Yeah.
I a stripper, and I got a clap.
Oh, because you pleasured a stripper with your face.
I did, yeah. Not to mention that I carried on and I, yeah, you know, yeah, whatever.
Yeah.
Sound
yeah. And did you have a baby?
I did, yeah.
You had a baby with a stripper?
I did. And the thing is, I had a girlfriend at the time.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh,
she
yeah.
should have told her it was part of the lap dance.
Hang on.
It was
the
towel's fault.
It gets better. I convinced her to tell the stripper that it's her boyfriend's baby. And, well, 4 years now, and I still don't technically have a kid.
Why does that get better?
Well,
so you're a loser.
I am a loser. Yeah, that's right.
No.
You're a deadbeat. Hey, get the Rob Ford update?
No.
Oh. Stepped on the scale.
And? How much?
After taking a few weeks off, today's scale showed 311 pounds.
He's up. What did I say?
I think you said about
315. I said 6 to 8 pounds.
Yeah,
you gained
said,
5.
Yeah. Oh,
man. Boom. Suck it. Boom. Boom. Boom.
What an example.
Boom. Boom. Okay,
if you went boom, boom, it might not be 311.
Yeah. I said earlier, Rob Ford gained six to 8 pounds, I believe. Didn't I?
You did.
Gained 5.
5?
That hog. Gained 5. 311. What, he start at 330?
Yeah. Wouldn't it be funny if it ends up at like 340?
He just goes.
If it's cut the waist challenge, yeah. Oh, if he got to 400, yeah. That'd be awesome.
Yeah, my waist went down, but then my boobs grew.
Yeah.
Yeah. I got a clip of the actual weigh-in. You want? I got a clip of it. You ready? Hey, there's a pound. Lost a pound.
299.
How much is farts? How much do farts weigh? Because I got to clear some room and I'll be like 309. I mean, I'll be eating while I do it, but it's a private time.
Dude, you think about it. 2 weeks, how many weeks in that? It's 52 weeks. So let's say 25 weeks, and he does 5 pounds every 25 weeks. That's a lot of weight. That's like an extra 100 pounds. So go for it, big guy. Time for some more open phones and we'll get out of here. Hi, The Edge.
Hey, Dean.
Hey.
Hey, I want to know, like, over what period of time did he gain another 5 pounds? Was it 1 week or 2 weeks?
2 weeks. Rob Ford just, he canceled his weigh-in last week because apparently he just chowed down. Then he did his weigh-in this morning at 9, and he gained a total of 5 pounds. So now he's back up to 311.
Like, over your basic caloric intake, that's another 18,000 calories. How do you accidentally 18,000 calories when you're on a diet?
Oh, what's this under my pillow?
Is it late night eating?
I had a real issue with the 3 liters of ice cream.
In order to maintain his weight, it would just be probably about 18,000 calories, and then another 18,000. Like, that's an incomprehensible number.
Okay, so put it in perspective. If you do, you understand nutrition, obviously, because you've done the math with the calories.
Because I'm trying to lose weight myself, and, you know.
How much do you
calories
weigh?
Calories in, around 200.
And how tall are you?
5'10".
Oh, okay.
Well, it's not too bad.
Well, you know, got to lose some.
You're fighting weight. You're good. So you understand, like, put it in perspective, 18,000 calories. How many, what types of meals and how many meals are those?
You're supposed to eat, you know, for my weight, I'm supposed to eat probably
1,500
calories in a day in order to maintain my weight.
Yeah.
You know, and I can still eat healthy and eat right, and I still come in under that. I don't have to eat, like, flax or cardboard or boring, you know, garbage. I can eat whatever I want.
Okay, so what I was asking, though, and I think you'd have to go and figure it out on, like, a calculator. Maybe that's what you're doing.
Yeah.
Are you figuring it out right now on your calculator?
Oh, me? No, I wasn't. I thought he was.
No. Because like two pizza pops is like 800 calories. So you'd have to have 10. You'd have to have probably 30 pizza pops in 2 weeks.
You got to sit around a lot. You got to eat a lot.
Two a day.
You could drink a lot. Like when I say drinking, like high calories and booze.
18,000. That's like Elvis was on 20,000 a day. And he died taking a dump. That's a fact.
It's the only way to go. That's what you shoot for.
That case of Coke just fell in my mouth.
Yeah, I guess that's an interesting perspective, though, what he said.
Yeah.
It is. To maintain that weight already is eating too much.
So
isn't that interesting?
That's an extra 10 days on top of his 14 days. That's an extra 10 days of eating. So in 14 days, he really put 24 days of eating in. Think about that.
It's a lot of eating, Dean.
That's willpower. Now, that's a guy you want running the city.
I'm stressed.
Nothing takes the edge off like 12 butter muffins.
Leave me alone.
You know what would go really nice with these French fries? More French fries.
Hey, the Edge. Hello. Hey, the Edge.
Hey, how you doing? I just wonder if I can go through and comment on the whole weight loss thing with Rob Ford.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Okay, yeah, I just wanted to, I actually am promoting a 90-day health challenge, and I had a lot of insight and info to help these guys out.
Okay, what is it?
Maybe I could even drop my website, get a free plug in there.
I'm sure you could. You're on the air right now, by the way.
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah. So what do you do for a living?
I'm sorry?
What do you do? Are you like a health person?
I'm in the health and wellness industry, yeah.
Okay, so like, put in perspective, 18,000 extra calories over a 2 week period.
Yeah, that's
What are we talking? Like, take us through 18,000 calories. What do you have to eat 18,000 calories?
A lot of junk food.
So that's probably all crap, like Coke and pot and ice cream and.
Yeah, absolutely. Maybe large pizzas to himself. Chase it down with a tub of ice cream, sort of speak.
So we're not joking around.
No, not at all.
So we actually might be accurate.
Yeah, we're experts.
No, all right. No whatsoever. So.
All right. And what did you want to do?
I'm actually promoting a 90-day health challenge. If I could maybe get my website out.
Sure.
It's northyork.bodybyvi.com. Vi.
Okay.
Cool, buddy.
You must be Vi, I take it.
Straight all the way.
All right, dude. Good luck. 18,000 calories. I got to look up what 18,000 calories is.
Well, we did, because Derek had a lot of food the other day.
Yeah, the day we had those Glory Hole Donuts in here.
There's this company named Glory Hole Donuts, which makes these incredible donuts that we don't recommend you probably eat more than one. I'm sure they would say the same. And Derek had, what, two?
Two, I had two.
But you also had a breakfast sandwich, didn't you?
Yeah, I had a bunch of stuff that
And you also had a Coca-Cola.
Yeah.
And you were still only
and a
at
Twinkie.
Like,
did you get the Twinkie?
Oh, yeah, Twinkie, that's what it was. And it was still like only 1600.
Yeah, it was only at like, not even, it was like 1400.
Mm-hmm.
Like, think about that. And he was eating everything that morning. That was
and these donuts had like fried chicken on them and bacon.
Yep. And you
and
ate
candy
them.
Floss.
Oh, they were good.
And that was like, that was the worst eating I've ever seen. Keep in mind, Midas had 4,000 calories one morning when he had like a whole bunch of those double downs we made him eat.
Oh, and they're back too. I can't wait. Huge. There's even a spicy one now.
27 Big Macs, 18,000 calories is 27 Big Macs. Just to let you know, this is 1,800 calories. One cup of cantaloupe cubes, some cottage cheese, six holy crackers, calorie-free beverage, meat, peanut butter and jelly sandwich, peanut butter, a tablespoon of fruit, apple beverage, 5 ounces of meat, five baked potatoes, salad, carrots, snack. You get yogurt, wheat germ, syrup, calorie. This 10 of those in, that's what he was eating in. He was eating 10 of those in a day.
We think.
The equivalent of.
Because I don't think there were a lot of carrots in this diet.
No.
Okay.
No, there weren't a lot of carrots in his diet.
In the Goldschlager.
On a very serious level, chocolate-covered
carrots.
This is a challenge that was supposed to set a precedent.
In the Goldschlager. That's all the carrots he had.
The Dean Blundell Show, 102.1 The Edge.